What's going on YouTube? It's Sean here and I'm back today to give you guys something a little bit different. So in today's video, I'll be talking about the Peak TP7 in this white and black colorway. This is actually my first exposure to Chinese brand Peak, and they sent me over a pair of these TP7s, which is of course Tony Parker's 7th signature sneaker from Peak. Yes, Tony Parker is retired from the NBA, but I gotta say, this 7th edition is probably his best looking pair so far. So at the time that I'm filming this, I'm not exactly sure what the Canadian retail price on these or if they're going to be even available here in Canada. But if I do get that info after I record this video, I'll definitely add that down in the description box below. So I got this pair about a week ago and I did have the opportunity to play a couple runs of ball in them. Of course, only wearing these two times isn't going to give me the best idea for a proper review for you guys. But there were some things I noticed that I will bring up later on in the review. So jumping straight into the upper, the majority of the upper of the sneaker is constructed using this black knit. So while the majority of this knit upper is lined with additional lining on the interior, the knit around the center of the shoe and around the ankle collar area is not lined and it's very, very stretchy and flexible. This allows for ease to get your foot into and out of the shoe. On the medial side, we have these reinforced eyelets, which help to lock down your foot in place. And then in terms of laces, these come with a rope style lace in black, which are laced up in this sort of asymmetrical fashion. At the very top of the tongue, we have this circular patch which has the Peak logo on the right foot and Tony Parker's logo on the left foot. Starting from the midfoot of the lateral side and extending and covering the toe box, here we have this shroud which is constructed out of this white synthetic material that almost has this feel of leather. If you take a real close look, you'll see it sort of has this checkerboard finish to it, which adds some visual interest to this otherwise monochromatic shroud. Found on the interior of the shoe and hugging your back Achilles area, there is a ton of padding back here. So as a result, when I wore these, the back Achilles area of my foot felt quite contained. As we move towards the back heel, so here we have this overlay of this black synthetic material, and as you can see at the very top, it sort of angles outwards, essentially acting as a heel pull tab. On the right foot, we have Tony Parker's number 9, and then on the left foot, once again, we have Tony Parker's initials. As I pull out the insoles, so these come with a very, very well padded insole. It's pretty much all done in black with this intricate design printed on top. And I honestly gotta say guys, compared to your typical basketball shoe made by an American company, this insole was very plush and super comfortable. So the upper of these TP7s sits atop this midsole, which is constructed out of Tai Chi technology. So this Tai Chi foam, which was introduced not too long ago, was initially put on a running shoe, but now they've incorporated that technology onto a basketball sneaker. So Peak Tai Chi, according to Peak, is a cushioning system that's supposed to basically be very dynamic with how you're moving. So when you're stationary and not moving, it's supposed to be very soft and plush, but then when your feet are striking the ground and you're moving quickly, it's supposed to firm up, giving you that nice responsive feedback. So because this technology can be very soft on feet when you're not moving, as a result, they've sort of contained it within this rubber carrier, which essentially covers the entire lateral side of the shoe. So you can see this sort of plastic finish on the lateral side. On the forefoot, we have Tony Parker's signature at the very bottom. And then underneath the heel, we have the Peak logo, which also acts as a heel counter as well. However, if you flip these over to the medial side, you'll see that this black foam right here, this is essentially the uncontained Peak Tai Chi foam. So by adding this rubber carrier on the lateral side, it does help with people who overpronate and overall just help contain that cushioning system a little bit better. If I turn these over to the bottom, so here we have your outsole. So this is entirely done in this semi-translucent and iridescent rubber. On the forefoot, we sort of have this star-like traction pattern. And then on the bottom heel, the traction pattern sort of resembles like an arrow. One thing to note, there is no visible torsional support along the midfoot, which some people may find is a deal breaker, but I personally didn't notice the lack of this support too much, but it's just something for you guys to consider. So from a sizing standpoint, my feet measures as a true size 10. It's slightly on the wider side. And usually for basketball sneakers, I go with a 10.5 because of the fact that a lot of basketball sneakers these days are cut a little bit more narrow. For example, the Kyrie line, a lot of my Kobe's, and the Zoom Freak ones, all of those I usually go with a 10.5. But I gotta say, the TP7s do fit true to size. They are very wide foot friendly, so if you guys do have wider feet, I wouldn't worry, you can stick true to size for this pair. And overall, from a length and width perspective, they were perfect in a size 10. In terms of how they were on the court, so first off, traction, which is very important, I found that the traction on this pair was actually very good. Though to be fair, I was playing on a very clean court, but with that said, I had no issues with slipping, and at all points during my two runs, the traction on this pair performed very well. Next up, from a cushioning standpoint, so I gotta say, as far as the actual cushioning goes, Tai Chi is actually the real deal. If I was just to wear these casually, I'd say that this foam is super, super soft, super plush, and it's honestly arguably right up there in terms of the most comfortable cushioning technology I've ever felt. And even compared to something like Adidas Boost technology, which in its own right is super, super comfortable, I honestly have to say that this Peak Tai Chi technology might actually be even more comfortable. Strictly comparing the two technologies from an actual comfort standpoint, the Peak Tai Chi actually feels softer on feet. With that said though, on the basketball court, that's a little bit of a different story. Myself personally, I prefer shoes that have more of a low to the ground feel because let's face it, I'm not much of a high flyer. So with that said, if you're looking for a shoe that's more in the mold of the Kyrie line or Steph Curry's Under Armour line, then this is probably not going to be the shoe for you. As I said before, the Tai Chi cushioning was super plush and it felt pretty elevated off the ground. So it's not going to be great for ground feel, but it gives you a ton of impact protection. If you are more of a power player or more of a high flyer and you want that added protection for your hard landings, or generally speaking, if you just prefer shoes that have a bit more cushioning underfoot, then these would be a great option for you. It really comes down to personal preference in terms of the cushioning setup you want on your basketball shoes. One thing I did like though is that they've extended this outrigger on the lateral side. So despite the fact that I did feel a little bit higher off the ground, I didn't feel at any point that my foot was going to roll over and I was going to sprain my ankles or anything like that. One final point I want to make is that these are a little bit more on the heavier side. So again, this kind of goes back to the conversation about being more of an appropriate sneaker for bigger power players. So with all that being said, now let me lace up these TB7s and I'll show you guys how these look on feet. Overall, and I'm being completely honest with you guys, this is my first experience with a Chinese brand sneaker. And I gotta say, before I had these in hand, before I played in them, my perception of these Chinese branded shoes were honestly a little bit more on the negative side. But after actually getting them in hand and playing in them, my opinion has definitely changed. I'm very, very impressed with this Tai Chi technology, and I personally can't wait to try more lifestyle sneakers with the same foam setup in the shoe. So if you guys are looking for a very, very comfortable basketball sneaker, definitely try the TB7s. Share your thoughts, share your opinions, all that stuff down below. And if you guys like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Give me a follow on my Instagram at esco8. Check out my Twitter at sean.go and visit my website at seangoe.ca. So until next time, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I'll catch you guys in the next one.